Oh, Windows 10. If you play a large variety of games, it is sort of like taxes, utility bills, or homework. You have no option but to deal with them, but that does not mean you like it. Now, with Windows 7 officially out of support and the next OS Microsoft is focused on being closer to a mobile OS with a centralized app store, it seems that for the foreseeable future, you, like me, are stuck with Windows 10. I, like many other people, would really love it if Linux becomes a viable alternative, as Microsoft dives headfirst into making Windows more phone-like. And while tremendous progress have been made in the last few years, a lot of the big games are still not runnable, and the performance impact, especially on budget systems, is nothing to scoff at. So for now, I support Linux, but I'm stuck with Windows 10. Also, now I will know for sure that all the inevitable "just use Linux" comments in this video did not actually watch the video. Anyhow, Windows 10 is big. Every new update brings some other things that are loading in the background, so every time you want to game, you have to deal with Windows Search, Cortana, OneDrive, the Microsoft Store, and many other things that you cannot easily get rid of. If you're using an old or very weak CPU in a low-end PC, you probably have noticed this, and wondered in frustration what could be done. In the past, I did a video on some of the destructive scripts that you could use to get rid of a lot of that, and significantly reduce the RAM used to the point that Rocket League stopped crashing on a 2GB RAM PC, and reduce occasional slowdowns due to background CPU usage. In subsequent videos, I commented on the existence of some unofficial light version of Windows out there that comes with a lot of that stuff already removed, but I did not recommend it because installing an unverified modified version of an operating system from some place in the web, if you plan to store any sensitive information on it, is obviously a bad idea. Since then, literally hundreds of you have written to me to suggest two other interesting options. One is Windows Enterprise LTSC, long-term support channel. Those are basically oldish enterprise versions of Windows that are supported with security updates for 10 years, and therefore lack things like Cortana or the Microsoft Store, which can make them a fair bit lighter. But as far as I'm aware, the only legal, free version of LTSC is a 90-day trial from the Microsoft website. And if you're already starting to write a comment about how you can get it for free in some other places, like, I don't have to call legal again just to tell you the legal issues of that. And that takes me back to the initial problem of running an operating system which you might use for sensitive information that you got from an unverified source. So, what can we do? Well, you can get an official clean version of the latest version of Windows from their website, which will work forever with some features disabled and a warning message, and modified it to make it as light as possible. Oh yes, many of you have sent me this program called WinToolkit that allows modification of a Windows ISO. Here's how that works. Step 1 is to download an official Windows 10 ISO from the Microsoft website, link in the description. This will provide a program on which you can select to download the file to your hard drive directly from Microsoft servers. If you install a program like 7-Zip, you can then extract the ISO to a folder, which can take a bit, but from there in the sources folder, you're going to look for a file called installed.win. If you have it, great! But at the time of writing, the latest Windows version has an install.ext, and that needs to be converted. This can be done from PowerShell as an administrator, which you can open from the file explorer in the same directory from the file menu. In there, you use this command so you can get the index of the Windows version you want to install, which in my case is Home Edition, so number 1. And then with that index, use this command to transform that into an install.win, which might take a while. All of these commands are in the description, so you can just copy and paste as long as you're in the correct location. Now, once you have downloaded WinToolkit, you can go to the Advanced tab for a thing called the Component Removal, where you can check all the programs and components included in this installation, and more importantly, remove them. You will have to select the newly created .win file, and this is where the fun begins. Now let me make this clear. This is not an official process. Windows was not designed for this sort of thing. This will break things and possibly cause severe bugs. Some trial and error and common sense will be required to make a stable, light version of Windows, but there are some logical steps that you can take based on some of the stuff that is auto-classified by WinToolkit. For example, usually, Stuff in red is so ingrained in the system that removing it might impossibly break everything, like for Windows Media Player. But if you're going to use your PC for a very simple and specific thing, like playing games or surfing the web, you can, for example, remove all the advanced networking components and internet information services or all the stuff related to printing. Be careful of anything that requires removal of .NET frameworks, because those are needed for a lot of programs and games. Now, on the system section, it is when things get really interesting. Most of the stuff labeled as green, you can usually remove safely, and the description or name gives you a pretty decent idea of what you're removing. So if you are sure about what features you will not be using, such as not being able to encrypt your hard drive, you can remove BitLocker. The big exception here is .NET Framework, which is used by a lot of programs, including games. However, some of the other removable stuff here is worth highlighting. For example, in my experience, the biggest occasional strain on CPU usage and disk usage are Windows Search and Cortana. Cortana is the voice control assistant that you never seem to be able to get rid of, and while this is labeled as critical, you can't, if you are bold, remove it and most of the system will work. Removing Windows Search means that typing the name of a program to get it in the start menu will not work. Apart from that, if you remove Windows Defender, keep in mind that you might need some other antivirus, so that gain sort of cancels out. Hello Face is needed for logging with your face or fingerprint scanner. Windows Mixed Reality will be needed if you use a Windows Mixed Reality headset like the one I have shown before, and PowerShell is a tool that many people use and need for any advanced control, like the one that we did on this very same video. Up to you what you keep and what you remove. Also, down here are the Windows apps that are included with Windows 10. Keep in mind that if you remove stuff like the camera or the picture viewer, you will need to download substitutes to watch your pictures or take photos with the webcam. Also, some people like to keep the Windows Store around for some games are sold there, and the Xbox app set are vital for the game overlay that can come in handy to record video clips. Although, if you are on a very old or low-end PC, that is likely a function you are not interested in. After you are done, you can press Remove Components, and given enough time, the program will take all of those selected elements out of the Windows installation. Then when you close, you select Save and Rebuild, and once that is done, you're ready to create a custom ISO. The tool to do that is in the Basic tab as ISO Maker. All you need to do is to set the source as the folder where you extracted the original Windows ISO to modify it, and set a destination for the modified ISO to be written to. After the modified ISO is created, you can create a Windows install USB stick with Rufus or similar programs, in any way that you usually install a complete copy of Windows. So, will this give you more FPS in games? The answer is complicated, and usually no. If you are GPU bottlenecked on most games, as most people tend to be, this procedure is unlikely to affect performance. However, if you are on very low memory conditions, as I mentioned on my last video on the topic, where I was using a 2GB computer stick, this sort of modification is tremendously useful in freeing extra memory to avoid games stuttering or crashing. In the case of CPU bottlenecks, do not expect extreme miracles compared to just using a deep loading script, but you can definitely expect less occasional slowdowns due to background usage spikes and just a generally more usable system. I merely wanted this for my dual-core Intel Celeron Edition GPD Pocket, which as time goes, takes longer and longer to open programs, menus or select options, and a less CPU-intensive version of Windows did a world of difference. Before leaving, I have to give a mention to Chris Titus Tech. Many, many of you linked me to a video he did about this topic, and while sadly a lot of the details have changed as the programs have updated, he does go into a lot of detail into this topic if you want to learn more, so link in description. Thank you to everyone who sent me information and recommendations for this topic. I can now refer to this video every time I use a custom version of Windows.